Good morning, students. Today we will continue our chapter, My Childhood. So, yesterday in the last video we were talking about Kalam's science teacher Siva Subramania Iyer, and he had a very conservative wife. He belonged to Brahmi family, traditional Brahmi family. And here Kalam is saying that Siva Subramania Iyer, he used to spend hours with me, and one day he told me, Kalam, I want you to develop yourself so that you are on par, you can be equal with the highly educated people of the big cities. And here he, Kalam is saying that one day his science teacher Siva Subramania Iyer invited Kalam to his home for a meal, and his wife was horrified because he was very conservative. Actually, she belonged to traditional Brahmin family, but when Siva Subramania Iyer invited Kalam for a meal in his house, then his wife became horrified at the idea of a Muslim boy being invited to dine in her ritually pure kitchen. Okay, she refused to serve meat in her kitchen, and Siva Subramania Iyer was not perturbed. Here the meaning of not perturbed means he did not become anxious, means he was not anxious, or nor did he get angry with his wife. Actually, she became horrified, and because she didn't like the Muslim boy being invited to dine in her ritually pure kitchen, that's why she became horrified and she disliked him. But Siva Subramania Iyer was not perturbed. He didn't get anxious and he didn't get angry with his wife, but instead served me with his own hands. Means Siva Subramania Iyer, Kalam's science teacher, he didn't get angry and he served the food with his own hands and sat down beside me to eat his meal. His wife watched us from behind the kitchen, and when they were taking food, they were taking meal, Siva Subramania Iyer's wife was watching then beside the kitchen door, and I wondered whether she had observed any difference in the way I ate rice, drank water or cleaned the floor after the meal. And here is Kalam saying that I got shocked whether she had observed, when she was observing us, the differences in the way I ate rice and drank water and cleaned the floor after the meal. When I was leaving his house, Siva Subramania Iyer invited me to join him for dinner again the next weekend. And after the meal, I was leaving the house of the science teacher. He again invited me to join him for the dinner again the next weekend, and observing my hesitation, he told me not to get upset. Actually, I was hesitated, and he observed that hesitation of me, and he told me not to get upset, saying once you decide to change the system. And his science teacher Siva Subramania Iyer told him not to get upset once you decide to change the system, and such problems have to be confronted. Here the science teacher is saying to Kalam that these types of problems are in the society, and we should face these problems. And when I visited his house the next week. And here Kalam is saying that he invited again me. And when the next time I went to his house next week, Siva Subramanya Iyer's wife took me inside her kitchen and served me food with her own hands. Actually, he became horrified. Kalam became horrified, shocked. That earlier she refused to serve the food to Kalam, but next time she herself served the food to Kalam with her own hands. And then the Second World War was over, and India's freedom was imminent. Here, again, next he is saying that the Second World War was over. After the Second World War, and India's freedom was imminent. India's freedom was nearest, and Indians will build their own India, declared Gandhiji. And after the freedom, Gandhiji declared that Indians will build their own India. The whole country was filled with an unprecedented, optimism means incomparable hopefulness. The hopefulness that cannot be compared of any other thing. So they were filled, means Indians were filled, all country was filled with that hopefulness. And here Kalam is saying that I asked my father for permission to leave Rameshwaram and study at the district headquarters in Ramanathapuram. And after that I asked, Kalam asked to his father to get permission to leave the Rameshwaram and study at the district headquarters in Ramanathapuram. He told me as, and then when he asked, when he got the permission from his father to leave Rameshwaram and continue study in Ramanathapuram, he told me, Kalam's father told Kalam that as if thinking aloud Abul, he told his name Abul, Abdul Kalam, I know you have to go away to grow. And does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without a nest? He asked. Means Kalam's father asked, you want to go? You want to grow away? Means here I know you have to go away to grow. And does the seagull not fly across the sun? Here he gave the example of a seagull. Does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without a nest? Here he quoted Khalil Gibran to my hesitant mother. Means here Kalam's father gave a quotation of Khalil Gibran to my hesitant mother. And here Kalam's father told Kalam's mother, your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. Means your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing, means life's desire for itself. And they come through you, but not from you. They came through you. They come through you, but not from you. And you may give them your love, but not your thoughts. For they have their own thoughts. Because every child has his or her own thoughts. So in this way here, this story was an extract of the Wings of Fire, and this is the autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam.